guys, welcome back to my channel. So today is going to be a very relaxed, casual video, and I have a feeling that this video is going to be a little long, which is why like I'm in a sweatshirt and like leggings. Like it's going to be a very just a long sit down video, and I want it to be as comfy as possible. So grab a snack or something, because we have a lot to talk about, and I'm really grateful that you guys actually decided to watch this video, for those of you who are, because it's not going to be very educational on your end. It's just going to be really just about me, what I've been doing, what's going on in my life, and just more of, I guess, like reflection and things that I do want to talk to you guys about, because I feel like I could see a lot of future videos coming out of the things I want to talk to you guys about in my update video on like what I've been doing for the past 5 months when I wasn't doing YouTube and just kind of like disappeared. I was a little reluctant doing this video. Like I'm still like a little nervous. Like I can feel like my heart beating, because I'm definitely going to be talking about topics that are way more sensitive to me. And at first they're a little bit more like to the point where I wasn't sure if I really wanted to share it with you guys. But again, like I feel like I could see a lot of learning and future videos coming out of every single one of the topics I talk about today. The first thing is that I no longer work at Purity Cosmetics. That's not the good part. I guess like the good news is that, you know, I switched careers, and for me it was the right decision. So right now I work at John Masters Organics. If you haven't heard of the company, I will link it down below. They are similar to Purity Cosmetics in the all natural organic beauty care products, but they only do hair care and skin care and a couple miscellaneous body products, whereas 100% Pure does cosmetics. So I no longer, I guess, work in cosmetics, but I am the global marketing manager there. So I'm working a little bit more in marketing, which is something I've always wanted to do. And Purity Cosmetics, as you guys know, I was doing more product development. I still love both of them. I still get to work really closely with the product development team at John Masters. So I've really been enjoying my job. I'm like, oh, like I'm like in like my sweatshirt. It's actually really cold in my apartment or my townhome right now. But anyways, okay, let's just bring back my hands. In that sense, I know you guys are gonna have a lot of questions about that. So I will be doing a future video about, you know, career changes and how I got my June job and how it was leaving, you know, a company that I supported so much and I still to this day want to succeed so much. But yeah, so that's really exciting. The whole change of job kind of just threw a curveball at me, and a lot of adjusting going on. It's definitely a lot more time consuming on my end. So for that matter, yeah, that has been taking up a good amount of my time. So if you guys follow me on Instagram, you guys are probably seeing that I've been hanging out with Susie Wang a lot. She's the founder of 100% Pure. And I can honestly say that I just want to give her a quick shout out, because she has been such an important person in my life, especially the year 2016. We just became so much closer, and she is such an inspirational woman. She is so intelligent. She has created this awesome brand, and I'm just so lucky to be able to call her as one of my good friends. And I do really want to actually bring her on to my YouTube channel and to, like, I don't know, for you guys to like ask her questions or something. I'm gonna have to figure out a way to do this, because you guys can learn so much from her, because I've learned so much from her. I'm still learning so much from her to this day. I'm gonna show you to like everyone, okay?
Okay. Hi! Hi everyone!
Probably like the best person that's happened to me in like 2016.
You're like one of the best things that's happened to me in 2000, or in my life, ever.
Oh, Susie. Okay, so I had to cut it off because we actually started talking about other things. 2016 was such a whirlwind. I will be getting into that, but all I have to say is like thank you so much to Susie and for like supporting me and just being there for me and like such a great friend. 2016, I don't know where I would have been without her, definitely. So now for more of the sensitive parts of what's been going on in my life. So I guess the one thing that this isn't really necessarily a bad thing or a good thing, it's just something that needed to happen. Me and my boyfriend of 5 years broke up, and if any of you guys have been in like a relationship for that long, you would know like it's very life changing. You know, it took a lot. I'm not gonna go too in detail like right now probably about like what happened and everything, but you know, it was definitely something that needed to happen. I definitely can say I'm so much happier now that I'm not in the relationship. But with that said, it definitely took a lot of learning just how to be an individual again. And I don't mean that in the sense that I know I'm an individual, like I have my own job, I have my own life, I am who I am. But when you're in a relationship with someone, you're kind of seen as like you have that other person. And it was just definitely taking some getting used to, just realizing I don't have him there as a support system anymore. Like it was just definitely just different for me, like being, I guess, single and just like alone. The breakup definitely has made me such a better person, I'd say. Like, I'm so much happier. I just seek so much more out of life, and I'm just not willing to settle, and I'm just definitely more happier, driven, ambitious, like just more willing to like do things for myself. And I couldn't be happier. But again, it's still a breakup, so definitely still some emotions were going on, but it was definitely something that definitely needed to happen. So I wouldn't say that was the main reason I wasn't on YouTube. It was just a combination of everything. But the main reason that I haven't really talked to that many people about has been more of like family things. My aunt, I've actually posted a couple photos of her on my Instagram because she's such an amazing person. She is such a important person in my life. She's been there with me since day one. So you guys probably don't know this, but my parents were divorced, and so my mom was, you know, a single mom working hard, providing for three children. And my aunt was definitely a person that she, you know, seeked help from in helping raise me and my brothers. And my aunt was just always there for me. She was always over at our house, like pretty much like three times a week, I would say. She would always be there. And, you know, whenever I had like a fight with my mom or my dad, she was the person I would call. She was just, she's basically my second mom. She is my second mom. Like, what am I saying? And this past year, 2016, she had a stroke, and she has not been the same ever since. You know, it was a clot in her brain, and, you know, your brain, yeah. I don't want to get too much in detail, like, the medical things that happened, but also, after that, like, literally 2 months after she had her stroke, she also has stage 4 cancer. She's alive, and, you know, like, I'm so grateful for that. She didn't pass away for anything, but just, like, seeing the changes going on through my family, just seeing the changes in her, and, like, how do I help her? It's just a lot. Not having my boyfriend there as a support system, I was feeling very on my own. I know I still had my family, I had my friends. Everyone has in my life, like my immediate life, has been so supportive of me and just being there for me, and I thank every single one of them. But still, like, there was a lot of just me feeling like still just so like alone. And not in like a depressing way. It was just more of like, I'm going through this family problem, and then I also don't really have the support system that I used to always have. So in that sense, there was just a lot of confusion and just getting used to it, and just well-needed family time. But I've also just really been enjoying my life, and it's just made me so aware of just how important my friends are to me and my family members, but definitely just my friends. I've never taken my family for granted, definitely. But I definitely think I'd taken my friends for granted, and after like everything was going on, I was really seeking out like mending old friendships and just really taking the time to hang out with everyone. And to be honest, like, that was just taking up all my weekends. Like, I wanted to see, like, I wanted to be around my best friends. I've constantly just wanted to be surrounded by people and just not left at home alone. I just started going out more and just constantly hanging out with my friends. Like, just going out, not like going out, like partying it super hard. I mean, definitely did some of that. And as you guys know, like, YouTube is not my full-time job. Monday through Friday, I'm working like over 9 to 5, actually. And then I come home and I'm tired, or, you know, like, I just need time to unwind. And then on the weekends, you know, that used to be my time when I would film YouTube videos. And with everything changing, that just was not the case. Like, on the weekends, I was just never here. So I guess now it's just been the time where I guess I'm just in a better place. I'm just more comfortable about what everything's going on. I'm just more used to it, and I'm just able to adapt better. YouTube is something that I love doing. It's such an amazing hobby for me. It just gives me so much fulfillment in life. And if you saw my like video about like my parents, and I did talk a lot about fulfillment and happiness and doing what makes you happy, and YouTube is something that makes me so happy, and I just missed it. I just craved just filming a video and, you know, the editing process of it, and then just seeing your guys' comments. Like, I miss so much of it, and that's why I really would love to make 2017 the year where I dedicate more of my time to YouTube. Because in the beginning I was like YouTube, and then everything kind of just like fell, and then life happens. There are some things that I feel like you can learn a lot from, about just learning about people's stories and where their hardships came from and how they got out of it. And I have learned a lot about myself through some of the hardships I've gone through. So I do want to eventually film videos about that. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching this. I hope you guys kind of enjoyed and just got a little glimpse of everything that's been going on. But I will say I'm just so excited and just happy to be filming again. And, you know, I can't promise like a video every single week, but I do want to film more often and just be more connected with you guys. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye.